pretty fucking useless. Because, like, even you saw what he was using it for was pretty useless. And you can't even use it for that. You just shoot it out and it just dribbles along the ground. It's sort of like the lead bubble from Mega Man 2. Except it goes about the speed of a snail. And then it explodes. You know, in contrast to, say, the drill from Mega Man 4, which would go at the speed of light and then explode. Pretty useful. But that's okay. I'm not going to use most of the weapons in this game. And it's okay, because I don't really have to. Yeah, G. Now, let's see. I think this is the only stage in this Mega Man game, and I think the only instance in any of the Mega Man games where there's those little hidden compartments that you just shoot the wall and there's something to find behind them, a little hidden room. I mean, there are plenty of hidden rooms in Mega Man, but usually they're like clearly, you know, labeled, they're like you can clear to see them. They're just like alternate paths. Like, hey, break this block and you can go to this direction, and you can find an item there, or something like that. But in this one, you have to break those blocks that look, you know, kind of conspicuous. And you slide into a hidden room. Which hides a couple of the... Like, if you were going to play this game and you didn't know where to start, this would probably be a really good starting place. I know I started with, who did I start with? I started with Gravity Man. Because, mostly because all of the stages... By the way, I'm going to interrupt myself. See that little path that I opened up that I didn't go into? I didn't go there because there's nothing there for me now. Because there's an M-Tank in there. And if you don't know what an M-Tank is, I'm not going to spoil it, but I'm going to use it later. And you're going to find out why there's only one in the game. I picked up one in, if you remember, the Crystal Man stage. And, since I picked up that one, I can't pick up another one. There's only one will be in existence that you can pick up at any given time in this game. Because they're that damn good. And that's why they've never been used in any other game since. But they kind of brought back, like, you know, pieces of them. They kind of brought them back in a less overpowered way later on. Mostly just Mega Man X. They don't really appear in Mega Man. And even then, it took a while. So, yeah. Let's see. Hope I don't get stuck on this part and have to do it over again. Ah, you fucking asshole. At least the good part is you can just jump over here. And then the little platforms will respawn. So you can try again. Apparently when I hit the jump button, nothing happens. So third time, okay. Got it that time. Now I just have to respawn a thing so I can get across and continue my journey. But yeah, so like, if you've never played this game before, and it's like super hard, which, by the way, there's another alternate path right there to the right. I don't know if you saw it. Right there. I'm not gonna go there because I don't fucking give a shit. But I gave enough of a shit to open it up just to demonstrate it. There's just a couple of like health items and pickups in there. Nothing important. But if you ever play this game and you're looking for a good starting point, because you're like, oh, this is stupid hard, I don't know what the fuck to do. This is probably a good start, because you're gonna see this boss is pretty easy to kill. No matter if you have the weapon or not. Actually, if you have the weapon, it doesn't really make it any easier. It just makes it a little bit faster. And as you can see, there was a lot of stuff to pick up. There was an E-Tank. There was an M-Tank. And the stage isn't really all that challenging. And look at this napalm bomb. Look how fucking useless it is. It just fucking dribbles along. Even to hit the guy, you have to just be right in his face. And he has to not be moving. Or he has to be walking into it. So, yeah. Besides him, I don't think I'm ever going to use this bomb again. Which is a shame, because that color scheme is fucking awesome. I love it. I even like look on the little energy bar on the side. It's also lavender and gold, rather than just being that solid one color that most of them are. Fucking awesome. I love it. And just from a design point of view, it's just, I like to... Luckily, this guy's weapon, the Power Stone, sucks ass. And his color scheme, when he's using it, also sucks ass. So, I won't be using it very often this game. I'm using it on this guy, which, again, doesn't make this boss any easier. It just makes it faster. So, but, you know, this boss is actually, you know, can be kind of challenging. I thought he was one of the harder boss, probably the hardest regular boss in this game when I was first playing this game. Because he's relentless. Now, this makes me happy, where, like, I know I'm charging his shot, but I don't really need to. Because everything that you see here is going to die with just one bullet. The little train-mounted metals and little flying guys. They all die with just one bullet, which makes me happy. So now I'm on side of a train. Yay. Trains are cool, I guess. They did have some things, like in, I think it was just in Mega Man X. Or maybe there was something in Mega Man, I don't remember, where, like, the screen would vibrate and shake because you were, like, on a moving, you were inside of a moving thing. But it mostly just made you dizzy because it would just blur the screen and it was not very well designed. Not a good choice. But it works here. Just everything kind of just fidgets a little bit. And it's kind of cool. Makes sense. And there's another A. Mega Man has two A's. I don't know if you just noticed that there, but this is the first game where they changed the way the rush coil works. Which, it has the same principle. You jump on them and you jump up. But instead of just being catapulted off of him, you ride him and then he jumps up and then you can jump up off of him. Not nearly as useful as it was before. At least not really. You can kind of control your jump better, but you can't jump as high, as fast. It's kind of more awkward. But that's okay, because you're never going to see Rush again. Except for maybe the much later Mega Man games. But Mega Man 6, he doesn't appear at all. Well, he kind of does, but not in any of the same capacity. They completely turned him into an accessory, rather than a full-fledged sidekick. Which is kind of lame, but, eh, whatever. So basically, this guy just kind of runs around chasing you. And that's pretty much all he does. And all you have to do is just keep one step ahead of him, literally. And the Power Stones make it a little bit easier, but look how fucking useless this thing is. You can't aim it. It's almost like one of those shield type abilities, which, by the way, you do get a shield type ability in this game from Starman. But it's like a shield type ability that sucks ass. So, yeah, Charge Man's dead. Hope we never run into that asshole again. He gives you one of the worst items in Mega Man history, but it actually is kind of cool. Like, you kind of want to use it, even though it's not very productive. Like, you can use, which I'm going to use it on Wave Man, because it makes his fight much faster. Which, for Wave Man, the one exception to kind of the rule where most of the bosses in this game don't get easier, they just get faster to kill with their special weapon. This guy, it's the same principle. He doesn't get easier, he just gets faster. But since he is so relentless with his assault, it does make it a lot easier. Because most of the bosses in this game are pretty easy to dodge. You're way faster than them. Most of them just slowly jump around and toss easy to avoid projectiles. But this guy is relentless. He jumps around like crazy. So the faster you can kill them, the easier it is. Now here's one of those rare straight vertical platforming instances of Mega Man, which don't work very often because, you know, if you've seen the Ego Raptor thing, you know what I'm talking about. Here's the thing with the bubbles. So now in the next part, you need to be careful not to jump straight up because you will kill yourself. And you'll have to do the whole stage over again. And this is the checkpoint right here, which is a real kick in the balls. So now you're in a fucking little jet ski, which is pretty awesome. It's pretty cool effect. Scrolling backgrounds, three different layers of water, enemies attacking you from all sides. Not bad. Pretty good design. Can't use any charge shots, but hey, why would you want to? This makes it a lot more fun. Because you have to kill things in multiple hits, except for those dolphins. So now, got a little mini boss. He's kind of tough. It's almost like, it kind of reminds me of, the Dracula fight from Castlevania, where you have to jump over his ability at his little plasma beam at just the right moment, otherwise you'll get hit and die. And if you do, then you won't be able to shoot him adequately. So now, I'm staying in the middle, I'm deliberately getting myself hit, because I want to be in position so I can grab the floating letter icon that's on this stage. There's one in every stage, you have to get them all. And you can't come back to these stages, so you have to get them on your first run. There we go. Because sometimes it's like flooded with like a lot of dolphins, like there'll be two or three different dolphins jumping at once to guard it, and it's kind of tough. So, don't want to fuck it up. Want to make sure I get it. So here we go. Made it to the boss. And I don't know what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to kill myself. I'm sure Wave Man will gladly oblige. Okie doke. So now I'm gonna pull out my weapon with a full tank of energy and wail on this fucker. Now the charge kick is bad for the same reason that the top spin for Mega Man 3 was bad, and that in most cases when you use it, you will take damage. Because you have to be at such close range, and you know, depending on if you get hit by something before or after, you know, you might take damage, so it's bad for that thing. When you could just pull out your buster and do damage, you know, from long range, that's why you have a gun. But on the other hand, the little sliding attack always felt like it wasn't as well accepted as Mega Man's other abilities. You know, evidenced by the fact that when they made Mega Man 9, they took the shit out of the game, so you couldn't slide anymore. But the fact that they added a little charge kick to it, they turned it into a weapon, is pretty fucking awesome in and of it itself. You know? So, now I'm coming to the last stage, Starman stage. Which, again, is one of the only other instances in the game where they kind of play with gravity. But it's not the same as where you're changing where gravity is coming from. This just has much lighter gravity. Which I guess isn't anything interesting, because it's the same thing as if you were just playing underwater, like a Bubble Man stage. Except, you know, clearly they just didn't put the water in, but they added the same effect. But whatever, I like it. It's cool. And I don't think there's ever been an outer space Mega Man zone before, so I like it. It's cool. And I like the music too. It's kind of interesting. It's got a weird vibe to it. You cocksucker. This is why I hate these fucking... There's always one stage like this in every Mega Man game that just half the stage is instant death spikes across every inch. And your job is to jump at just the right trajectory to not instantly die. So I'm gonna pull out my jet. I'm gonna say, fuck all of you. I'm gonna just fucking bypass all this stupid bullshit. I don't even give a fuck. Don't judge me. So now, crisis averted. Well, maybe not. And you can still fuck up. You can get your head on all these spikes everywhere. Especially considering there's very low gravity, so you can't, you know, you have to be very careful with your jumps, because you'll jump really, really fast. I hate these guys. This is my least favorite enemy of all the Mega Man enemies in this game. Because the sweet spot is so small. One of the few instances where I'll use Gravity Hole to its effectiveness. Because Gravity Hole could be pretty useful, because it kills everything on the screen, pretty much. But, I don't know. It never comes up that often where it's actually... Actually, I think it only works on airborne shit. I don't remember. I'm pretty sure it does. So, it's not like you use it on anything. You can really only use it on, just flying shit. And Gyro Man, which is more flying shit. So, not very good. I don't know. I'm not sure if this makes sense from a chemical standpoint, but Starman's weakness is water. I don't know. It works, I guess. Somebody had to be weak to water. And since Snowman was already weak to bombs, I guess Starman had to be the one. Actually, he kind of gets easier from using his weapon against him. Because, you know, his main weapon, and his only weapon, really, is just that fucking star barrier. And since the waves knock it out and consequently hit him as well, kind of take away his entire arsenal. So now I'm bronze and gold. And I get the super arrow, which is a whole new weapon that you will only see in this Mega Man. You'll never see